Well, grace and peace to you from our Lord Jesus Christ, and I pray as David did in Psalm 19, let the words of my mouth and the meditations of my heart be acceptable in your sight, O Lord, my rock and my redeemer. Well, the title of my message is what Jesus said to the disciples. You give them something to eat. You give them something to eat. Jesus wants to partner with us. He does. Remember last week I talked about not giving just your leftovers to God, but to give your best to God? The first of your fruits? The first 10% of your income? And today, what we have is so little compared with what God has. But we have something. You know, I was a math teacher for a long time, and I know if you multiply anything by zero, you get zero, right? Yeah. Zero times infinity is zero. So if we bring nothing to the table, what's gonna happen? God, if he multiplies that, you'll still have nothing. So what little we have, we can bring to the table. Now this story is in all four Gospels. You know, in seminary I was taught if that happens, first of all, that's a miracle, because John is way off in left field somewhere, and sometimes he doesn't have the same stories as the rest of them, but he even talked about this. And what all of the stories have in common is that there were very few loaves of bread, and there was very few fish, and Jesus told the disciples to feed the 10,000, 15,000, 20,000 people, and they said, what? You know, in one story, a little boy had those fish. The disciples didn't have anything, but they did happen to scrounge up something. Now that's nothing compared to, you know, five loaves and two fish. That's nothing compared to 20,000 people, right? So what did Jesus do? He said, you feed them, and then they gave them what they had, and they decided to give that up to Jesus, and Jesus multiplied it. Not only did he multiply it to feed like 20,000 people, there were baskets of food left over. And the disciples had the privilege of distributing that food and giving the thankful looks in the people's eyes. And they also had the privilege of seeing the lavishness that God has towards his people. He wants to give us good things. He wants to give us a foretaste of the kingdom to come. Remember how I talked about the kingdom last week? It's just amazing what the kingdom is. Who wouldn't want to go there? You know, once you catch the vision of what the kingdom is like, there's no pain. First of all, that's a winner for me. If I was someplace without any pain, that's a winner, okay? But there's more than that. There's colors we haven't seen. There are talents that we've never had before. There's an infinite amount of things we can learn and do and be when we were with God. Did Jesus need the disciples? The answer is no. He could. Everything was created in and through Jesus, right? So could he just have snapped his fingers and then everybody had something to eat? Could they have something more than like fish and loaves? Could they have prime rib? I think so. But he uses the disciples. He wants to work with us. We are his disciples. So bring what you have to Jesus. Bring what you have to Jesus. Whatever it is, how little you think it is. Many of us are challenged because we don't feel we're good enough. We're not strong enough. We're not brave enough. We don't have the words to say. We don't fit. We're not we don't look like everyone else, right? How can I possibly influence that for Jesus? But bring what you have to Jesus, and you will be amazed at what he can do. Words will come to you. Actions will come to you in the situations you're in. You're not to worry about what to say or what to be. God is inside you, and he is with you. Jesus partners with you because he wants all people to come to him. And it could be the smallest thing that you do that could make a difference in someone's life. And you won't even know it. But Jesus can work in and through you. All I know is that if you bring nothing to Jesus, if he multiplies that, he gets nothing. You get nothing. Bring whatever you have to him. And he is the great multiplier. Let's pray. Gracious Heavenly Father, we thank you for your Son, Jesus. We thank you that everything we have and everything we are comes from him. Help us to give it back to him. Help us to give it back to you so that it can be multiplied, so other people can catch the vision of the kingdom of God through us and are drawn towards Jesus. Thank you, Jesus, for being such a great example to us, that you heal the sick and you do such good. You want such good for us. You want us to live and not to die. You redeemed us from our sin. We thank you for that. And you multiply any goodness that's within us so that other people are attracted to you. Holy Spirit, unite us. Holy Spirit, move within each one of us as we move into challenging situations. Help us remember that Jesus can make us more than we are. Give us the words to say and be able to draw people closer to him through us as he works in and through us. And we pray all this in Jesus' name. Amen.